Today we're going to talk about high flow vacuum pressure regulators. We're out in the laboratory. We're going to be using a Becker 5 horsepower vacuum pump today. This 5 horsepower vacuum pump is going to feed a vacuum reservoir tank. And coming out of this vacuum reservoir tank, we've got a vacuum gauge that shows us how much vacuum supply we have, and also an Equilibar high flow vacuum pressure regulator. Coming out of the Equilibar high flow vacuum pressure regulator is a flow control valve that's going to simulate the variable flow rate in your vacuum system. And that variable flow rate is going to be displayed on this Dwyer rotameter. And the actual pressure that the Equilibar vacuum regulator is controlling is going to be displayed on this pressure gauge. So if we come back over, we're going to start the vacuum pump up. And you'll see that the system vacuum is starting to climb. We're going to give it just a second to climb. I'm going to be able to set the vacuum pressure in the system by turning this hand knob. This hand knob adjusts the pilot to the Equilibar high flow vacuum regulator and determines the vacuum set point. So right now I'm going to set this at 10 inches of mercury vacuum. Now that's the pressure set point for the system. Right now the system is flowing about 2 SCFM. So I've got 2 SCFM of atmospheric air being pulled into the system. But the system pressure is being dictated by the Equilibar vacuum regulator. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show if there was variation in the system. I'm going to do that by turning this ball valve open. And you can see we've brought the flow all the way up to about 10 SCFM, five times more flow than we started with. Yet if we come back over to the Equilibar vacuum regulator, we'll see that we're still at our 10 inch of mercury vacuum set point. So the vacuum pressure is independent of system flow. The system flow can vary. Different things can happen in your system to make that happen. But the vacuum pressure is dictated and held by the vacuum regulator, the Equilibar vacuum regulator. Now, there's one more thing about using a regulator. Because it's a true active regulator, an active control device, I can actually have the system vacuum vary as well. And we're going to do that right now. We're going to take this system vacuum and we're going to drop it from about 22 and a half inches all the way down to about 15 inches of mercury. And as this happens, what I want you to notice is that, go ahead. As this system supply vacuum in this tank drops, what you're going to notice is that the actual controlled vacuum set point does not change. And the system flow rate does not change. Because it's an active regulator, system flow and system supply are independent of your set point pressure. Equilibar vacuum regulators are very high flow. The technology is very scalable. This is a 2-inch model. We currently build models all the way up to 4-inch NPT. If you'd like to learn more, visit our website at equilibar.com.